Hello and welcome to the first strategy video about the NTSE examination. My name is Shloak Vatsal. I'm KVPY All India Rank 51, NTSE Scholar. I've got 98% marks in CBSE board examinations. I've got All India Rank 5 in Talentix, All India Rank 6 in FTRE. I've qualified for Indian National Chemistry Olympiad and I was Jharkhand State Rank 2 in NTSE 2019-20. I'm a Koran, poet and a student. Let's start. We'll be discussing the following three questions in this video. What is the exam? What is the eligibility and pattern? And how to prepare by using what materials? So coming to what is this exam? NTSE stands for National Talent Search Examination. It is conducted by NCERT. It consists of two rounds. The first one is organized by the State Education Board and the second one is conducted by NCERT itself. About 2,000 students qualify this examination. They are entitled to a monthly scholarship of ₹1,250 in class 11th and 12th and ₹2,000 in the graduation level. Generally, the students of class 10th are eligible for this examination, but preparations should be started ideally in class 9th. Though, if you are in class 10, there's no need to worry as you will be able to clear the examination with proper hard work. Coming next to the examination pattern. This examination consists of two papers, which is of 2 hours each, and they consist of 100 marks each too, which leaves you with about 1 minute and 12 seconds per question. So this time, though it may look small, but is actually quite sufficient as you don't take more than 10 or 20 seconds on a question in SST. So the two papers are Scholastic Aptitude Test, which stands for SAT, and Mental Ability Test, MAT. So now expanding SAT a bit, it consists of three sections, SST, Mathematics, and Science. In Science, the physics questions generally consist of 12 or 13 questions, chemistry comes for 12, 13 or 14 marks, and biology too for 14 or 15 marks, though this pattern keeps on changing every year. The questions are of class 10th level, but you should complete the syllabus of class 9th and 10th. Now coming to how to prepare each subject individually. First comes SST. For SST, I would advise you to stick strictly to the NCERT syllabus or the state board if you are studying in that. Some states follow NCERT syllabus only, like my state Jharkhand, while some states like West Bengal and Kerala use their state boards to make the questions. Nothing extra should be done apart from these, though for stage 1 you can read a little about the state's history and geography. Try to make notes for SST. This is an important point. Notes will constitute an important part of your preparation because in the end, you'll not study from the books, right? For the first level at least, you'll have to study from your notes only. Coming to notes, you can actually take my notes too. I'll be posting it after reaching 500 subscribers. I'll start posting it in a few days only. The first video will come after the NECGS strategy video. So try to take down those notes and try to match it with your state board books or your NCERT books, though I've covered almost everything in them. So next, try to write things after learning. I've seen many students do not do this. This is a great way to learn something. Like if you read something after that, take one empty sheet and write everything you think that you learned. So in this way, you can check how much of it are you remembering and how much are you forgetting. For the things which you are forgetting, mark them as important and read them regularly. From regularity, we come on to our next point, which is revision. Especially for history and geography, you should revise the content which you have studied regularly. At least once in a week, you should open the chapters which you had done earlier and you should try to do them again. Next, coming to science and mathematics. For science and maths, I would recommend you to do something extra from 11th and 12th too. Though you can manage with what has been given in class 10th NCERT or state books, but an extra knowledge never harms. Some questions are generally above the class 10th level, those are the deciding questions which will decide what rank will you get in the end. So for biology, I would say you should stick to class 10th NCRT only. But if you want to do some extra reading, you can use this Selena publication book, which is taught in the ICSE schools. You can also use SChan books, though you should not go into theory of chapters like agriculture and all. They are given quite extensively in this book, but you should stick to the NCRT syllabus only. For maths, I would recommend you to do some extra geometry and number theory too. About number theory, I'll be posting a video soon, but for geometry, you can do what has been given in your class 10 books. So maths and science are relatively easier sections of these NTSE examinations. You should stick to the basics and try to get as much marks as possible by increasing your accuracy. Coming next to the mental ability section. For mental ability, I would say practice is the key. Why I'm saying that is because when you practice, you get to know different questions. And many a times what happens that for mental ability, the questions get repeated. And if you have a good grasp over the concept by practicing, you can refine your sword and you can easily get these questions correct. For mental ability, one of the major things which we have here is accuracy. I've jumped a few points, but let's see. This accuracy section, you'll have to do as much as possible. So generally what happens in states like Jharkhand and states like Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, the paper comes relatively easier. So you'll have to aim for 90 plus there. I too got 99 in the mental ability paper, and a few of my friends also got 100 out of 100 there. So just remember that I have listed some important chapters. So generally the questions in mental ability come from these chapters only. So NTSE has a pattern, and these are for stage 1. For stage 2, I'll make a video soon, and there I'll tell you which chapters are necessary for the second stage. So now coming to what materials to use. NCRT 9th and 10th, these are the master books for all subjects. So what happens is that generally the questions of SSC and biology are taken directly from NCRT books. Sometimes the maths questions are also taken from there, and physics and chemistry, the concepts which have been provided in the NCRT books are used to form different types of questions. For SSC, what you can do is to do class 6th to 8th NCRT. This is for stage 1 again strictly, because in stage 2 only NCRT questions are asked. For stage 1, you can take the help of class 6 to 8 SSC books of NCRT to study ancient and medieval history from there. A few questions come from there too. And my notes and question banks, as I have already told you, that at 500 subscribers, I'll be providing my notes. And at 1000 subscribers, I'll release question banks of different subjects. You may use them too to study and get good marks. Then there's a book by Arihant. It costs almost rupees 500. This is for those who need a lot of questions to practice, but are unable to grasp the concepts quickly. So what happens is that sometimes a person needs a lot of questions to understand something, right? So for those people, I advise them to use this book. It is a bit costly. And when I'll make the question bank, I'll try to include some questions from this book too. So you can do SST and science from here. For mental ability, you may try some online question banks or the question bank which I'll release. So about this announcement, you already know that I'll be releasing my notes and videos based on them on reaching 500 subscribers. I'll be releasing video on the notes of French Revolution after the NECJS video.